somebody, you don't take time before you come in. You don't take hot time before coming. Because you must be on your feet and you must shout. And when you shout, everything that is not of you will leave you. Are you ready? Wake up to me. Hallelujah. Just keep standing. I want to say, choir, I give you another kiss.
Glorious God, beautiful King.
want you to open your Bibles with me to the book of 2 Corinthians, even as we stand for the reading of God's word. Chapter number 12, verse 7 to verse 9. 2 Corinthians, chapter 12, verse 7, verse 8, and verse 9. If you are there, say amen.
Amen.
2 Corinthians, chapter 12, from verse 7 to verse 9. And I read, "And lest I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan." This sound is perfect. Thank you, sir. "The messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above measure. For this thing I besought the Lord thrice, that it might depart from me. And he said unto me," now watch the red letter words, "my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness." Now if you're holding the original King James with the red letters, with all of Jesus' words in red letters, you would realize that this particular portion is in red letters, which means it was Jesus speaking. And I want to read that again. "My grace." Somebody say the grace of the Lord.
Grace of the Lord.
Talk to me, church. Say the grace of the Lord.
Grace of the Lord.
He said, "My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of God may rest upon me." I just want to focus on, "My grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness." Now, let's go back to verse 7. And read from, it says, "There was given to me a thorn." Somebody say a thorn. Talk to me, church. Say a thorn. This is Paul speaking. "Since there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffet me, lest I should be exalted above myself." A thorn in the flesh. Drop your Bibles on your seat and help me give 5,000 people a high five and tell them, "We will deal with every thorn today. We will deal with every thorn." Sickness, the thorns of delay, the thorns of disappointment, the thorns of frustration, the thorns of premature death. Any thorn the enemy has released into our lives, we will deal with them today. Are you sure you've given 5,000 people a high five? Give 5,000 people a high five. Tell them, dealing with the thorns. Tell that person, receive grace to deal with every thorn in your life. Your throne. 10,000 words of man's wisdom, wherein is no profit. But let me come unto your people in a demonstration of the power of your spirit, that by the end of this service, chains and fetters will be broken and destroyed. That by the end of the service, the sick will be healed. That by the end of the service, the unsaved shall be saved. And by the end of the service, every work of Satan shall be destroyed in the lives of your people. And your glory shall be sent into the midst of us, and we will say in unison that of a truth, God has been gracious unto us. In Jesus' name, shout aloud, amen, and put your hands together for Jesus. Before you take your seats, please help me celebrate my wonderful friend and brother, your papa, the angel of this house, Apostle David Collar Williams. Let's celebrate him. Is this the way to celebrate your papa in town? Let's celebrate the great man of God, the gentleman in the kingdom of God. And of course, his lovely, sweet, gorgeous, pretty wife, Mama Bridget. We salute you, Mama. God bless you. Hallelujah. I salute all the wonderful men and women of God in the house. God bless all of you. God bless everybody that is present here. As you take your seat, put your right hand on your head and shout, I receive grace to deal with every thorn. You can take your seat in heavenly places. Grace. Now, yesterday I spoke about grace in the sermon, in the message. And it so happens that grace has repeated itself today. Can I pray for somebody here? From today, every day of your life, may you encounter God's grace. You didn't hear what I said. No wonder the psalmist said, goodness and mercy. That word goodness, interpreted in its original Hebrew word, is grace. Grace and mercy. Grace simply means receiving goodness you don't deserve. I spoke about that yesterday. And the psalmist said, goodness or grace and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life. Every single day. May grace follow you every single day from now. In the name of Jesus. May you bring your grace seat. Did you bring your grace offerings?
Yes.
Get yourselves ready. Yesterday, the prophetic direction that came is that each and every one of us is releasing a seed of 50 euros. You write it behind your envelope, grace seed, grace offering. Now, putting that seed in the envelope to release it, and your prayer is that, oh Lord, as I release this 50 euro seed, I told you in biblical numerology that number 5 signifies grace. And we are in the 5th month of the year. We are in the month of grace. And as you release the seed by faith, you know, sometimes some miracles are withheld from us because of the lack of obedience. At the moment we begin to live and walk and operate in obedience, God's goodness and God's mercies begin to follow our lives. Prepare yourself. In a short while, I will be collecting these grace seeds. We will drop them on the altar, and we will touch the horns of these altars, and we will make some declarations here. Did you also bring the shoe I told you to bring?
Yes.
Did you bring it? How many of you brought it? Show by hand. How many of you? How many of you? God bless you. If you didn't bring it, maybe you were not here last time. You can use the one you are wearing if you so desire. Praise the name of the Lord. You see, God operates through signs and tokens. And sometimes we do not see the move of God because we limit prophetic directions. I've seen people that have been delivered from terminal diseases through prophetic directions. I don't know if I've shared the testimony of a lady that was healed of HIV/AIDS in Vicenza or Verona. In Verona, my cousin lives there. And a friend of hers was suffering from HIV. She brought it. I just blessed a glass of water, told her to drink it. She traveled to Africa, tested, and it was negative. Came back to Italy, did the test again. It came back twice. And she couldn't believe it because she had already done tests in the past. I think three or so in the past. And they all came out positive. But after prophetic direction, this young lady was healed. I pray for somebody here. As you partake in this prophetic direction, may your own testimony be released into your life. Now let's quickly get into the word of God for the sake of time. Today I'll be reading some scriptures. Can I have a pulpit down here if that's okay? Now, from 2 Corinthians chapter 12, is it okay to just teach today? Is it okay? Is it okay? And then we will pray. From 2 Corinthians chapter 12, verse 7, that we read, Paul was speaking here, and he said that the devil planted something in his life, and he called that thing a thorn. Somebody say a thorn. Talk to me, church. Say a thorn. Paul is speaking to the church of Corinth, and he's telling them, the devil planted a thorn in my flesh. Now, what was the assignment of this thorn? He said, that thorn had been given to buffet me. It was a messenger of Satan. There is somebody sitting under the sound of my voice hearing me today, and you have a thorn in your flesh. There is something that the enemy has released to buffet your life. To buffet means to harass. There is a thorn that has been released into your life to harass. To buffet means to frustrate. To buffet means to wound. To buffet means to cause, to bleed, to afflict, to suffer, or to be under attack. Paul was under attack because there was a thorn in his flesh. I don't know what thorn the enemy has put in your life today, but I want to promise you, every single one of us sitting here is dealing with one thorn or the other. Some of you are dealing with marital thorns. Some of you are dealing with financial thorns. Some of you are dealing with immigrational thorns. That thorn is that thing that causes you pain. It causes you to bleed. It causes you to hemorrhage. That thorn makes your life uncomfortable. What thorn has the enemy put in your life? But as Paul and talking about the thorn and the pain that the thorn was causing in his life, he got to verse 9 and he made a very profound statement there. He quoted what Jesus said, and Jesus said, my grace is sufficient upon you. Can I talk to somebody here? I don't know what thorn you are dealing with in your life, but God sent me here to come and announce unto you, he has given you enough grace to deal with that thorn. Amen. You said this week and it is poor. Anything that has been frustrating your life, even up until now, anything that has been causing delays and disappointments in your life, even up until now, God wants me to tell you, you are graced enough to deal with that thorn. By the end of this convention, somebody is receiving fire to destroy every thorn. Your amen tells me you are not the one I'm talking about. You are always in a place of desperation because of the presence of this thorn. But I thank God for the presence of grace. God said that my servant Paul, even though Satan has sent this thorn into your life to buffet you, I have given you enough grace to deal with this thorn in your life. I pray for some people here right now. Whatever thorn is in your marriage, whatever thorn is in your finances, whatever thorn is in your body, whatever thorn is in your father's house or your mother's house, causing pain and frustration, may the fire of God drive you in that pond any longer. You are not hearing me. Now, project Genesis chapter 3, verse 17 and 18. Genesis chapter 3. Can I talk to somebody here? We will deal with every thorn in our lives today.
Amen.
Can I pray for somebody? You are not walking out of this room with another thorn in your life. Any thorn that has been present in your life, it will be destroyed before we leave here today. Genesis chapter 17. Now, Bible says after Adam and Eve had sinned, and God came to curse them, this is what the Lord said to man. He said, let us read from a bit now. He said, thou shalt not eat of it. No. Curse is the ground for thy sake. Now, God is cursing Adam because of his disobedience. And he said, the ground that produces food for you, the ground that produces products for you, the ground that is your source of blessing, it is cursed because of you. In sorrow shalt thou eat of it all the days of your life. Go to verse 18. Quickly. Thorns. Somebody say thorns. I'm not hearing you. Say thorns. Thorns and thistles shall it bring forth to thee. This was the first time, man of God, we heard of this word thorns and thistles in the word of God. Up until this portion of scripture, there was no thorn on the earth. When God was creating the heaven and the earth, he didn't create thorns. He only created herbs. He created fruits and vegetables. He created edible things, things that man could eat. Thorns are not edible. Thorns cause pain. Thorns cause you to bleed. And up until this point, there were no thorns in the Garden of Eden. But when God got ready to curse man, he said, from today, because I am releasing a curse on you, the ground will produce thorns. There are some of you hearing the sound of my voice. You are dealing with a thorn in your life because you are under a curse. Some of the thorns we are going through, in fact, every thorn you will be faced with is a product of a curse. Some curses from your father's side, some curses from your mother's side have produced thorns in your life and they are causing you pain. What is a curse? A curse is a blessing blocker. A curse will block your blessings. A curse is an enablement to fail. When we say somebody is cursed, it means they are empowered to fail. The opposite is a blessing. A blessing is an empowerment to excel. I lift up my hand to the heavens. I pray for certain people here right now. Any curse in your life, the way you are sitting down tells me you are not the one I'm praying for. Any curse in your mama's house, any curse in your papa's house, produce thorns and thistles in your life. Today they are broken and destroyed. Somebody shall fire. I declare you are free from the power of every thorn. You are free from the pain of every thorn. Shall yes. Someone hearing the sound of my voice is dealing with a thorn. I don't know what thorn it is, but before the end of this convention, by the time we set the grace and leave this place today, they put a crown of thorns. Somebody say thorns. I'm not hearing you. Somebody say thorns. They put a crown of thorns upon his head. Do you know the reason why? He carried the thorns, which is the curse, so that you don't have to carry it. So if you are still living under the power of a thorn, it is not the plan and the will of God for your life, because Jesus has already carried it. Some of you, your thorns are sicknesses. Your thorns are poverty. Your thorns are disappointments and delays. Your thorns are marital frustrations. I don't know what thorn it is, but if Jesus carried the thorn upon the cross, I pray for you that may any thorn in your life be broken and destroyed. You will not suffer the thorn any longer. You will not deal with So God said to Victor, I have given you grace to deal with the thorn. Any thorn in your life, we will deal with it today. I said, any thorn in your life, we will deal with it today. I'm not hearing your amen. So somebody shall fire. Somebody shall fire. And this fire or something is going against every thorn. Somebody shall fire.
Conversation with the snake, that was a thorn.